I'm finally facing it all. Fearless.
Hey guys, Darkbreaker here. We are playing Geena, the newest hero of Arena Valor now. So this is the little combo guide I will give you for Geena. She's a very high skill level hero. She has a high skill ceiling. And there are a bunch of combinations that you can do with Geena. So first of all, let me show you her abilities. Her first skill are two dashes, but you have to hit a hero or a minion. So for example, I use my S1 here, and then I use my S1 here, and I can dash two times. Her second skill throws like shurikens, and if you collect them again like here, you get cooldown reduction, and you can use your S2 pretty quickly again. Wait, let me get some gold so I have more cooldown reduction. And her passive is after 5 auto-attacks, after 5 auto-attacks or abilities, the opponent is getting silenced. It has a cooldown as well. So when you switch, you have with Geena the abilities to switch into two forms. I will call this form her blade or assassin form, and the other one is like more her warrior form. You switch. And you do AoE damage while switching. Then your second skill in this form is that you push your enemies back. And your first skill is you can charge and do a lot of damage. You can also charge in this direction, for example, and then you use charge in this direction, and then you use flicker to redirect your flicker. This is very important in your combinations. And if you collect the shurikens you sent in your assassin form and collect them during your melee form, you can use your S2, this ability, two times. I will show you right now. So now, for example, how a combination can work. You use S1, S1, use S2, use S2, you collect your S2, and then you can use your S2 again. Then you can use S1, and if you double tap on your S1 when you are using your your S2 is charging, your S1 is like your power skill that you charge with as well. I would call S2 the pushback skill and S1 the skill that you use to charge a lot of damage. The longer you charge, the quicker is your damage. And within the first 0.75 seconds while you're charging, if you cancel it really quick with your, if you double tap, it does the same damage like if you wouldn't charge. Like 0.75 seconds, within 0 and 0.75 you do the same damage, and then 0.75 to I don't know what. And then after, this is like in between intervals, it does more damage. It's not like every second it does more damage. So, I showed you the one where you can double push, and now I can show you another combo when you use it to minion, to a gap clapper, to gap clap. You jump to minion here, jump again, use your S2, push back. I charge again, see? My shurikens, and I can use my S2 again. So that's a combination that you always have to keep in mind. But usually it's fine to use your S2 like this. You use S2 first, S1, S1, S3 to switch. Then you use your S1 to charge, and then, for example, people are running away from you, or like you. Usually you hit your first S1, And then the second is one, people are running away, and then you can redirect like this. So that covered most combos. Let me show you a flicker combination that you can do. You can use... Wait, let me switch forms. You can use S1 and flicker. And I will show you this now, right here. Cooldown reduction. I will flicker, jump. This is a pretty quick combo. I didn't use my S2 while doing this combo. Let me do it again. Switch forms. S1 plus flicker mid-air plus S1 plus S2, then S3, then S2, then S1, double S1 plus S1, double S1. So when I say double S1, it means you press S1 really quickly, so you auto-cancel your first S1. Okay, let me show you. S1 flicker, S2, S1, switch, bum bum bum, S1 double, S1 double. That's the quick combinations, but you can also finish the combination with the long charge S1. So you use S1 like this, boom, and then he's running away. You use, like, for example, use in this direction and people are running away, and then you redirect. I think I finished most combos, and those are the basic combos. Maybe you can see more combos that I show in a gameplay. And if you like this little combo guide, of course, leave a like and subscribe, and let's hop right into the gameplay. Hey guys, Darkbreaker here. Today we are playing Jaina. Jaina is probably one of the most exciting Dark Slayer laners they released. For you guys who don't know, I played Jaina, or the King of Glory version, Hua Mulan, like 1 year ago. During that time, she was super popular, 100% pick and ban rate in competitive. We went there for the KCC tournament, and I was spamming her like so much. I think I spammed her like 40 games, but I didn't play her since then once. And I can say she is a really hard hero. Compared to most AoV heroes, she has a high skill ceiling because of her... she just has so many combinations that you have to learn, and then you need to be smooth with her combinations and her animations cancelling. And on top of that, she is very squishy, so it's hard for her to find the right engage into the enemy team comp. Right there, I didn't contest this because I knew the Morad was there, so I didn't try to contest the Morad. So, you see I did a lot of damage there. I jumped onto him, and then you try to predict where he's jumping next. Use your S2, so he gets more stacks from your passive. And when you use your S2 again, he gets silenced. And on top of that, he gets additional physical damage because of your passive. 5 auto attacks, he gets out 5. Any, you can do auto attacks for 1 mark, you can do skills for 1 mark. So it's a combination of, in total, 5 mark onto the opponent. Then the opponent gets silenced and you do additional damage. Right there we dive the Zuka, but unfortunately the Batman died, but we still get the double buff, so it's not too bad for us. One kill for Zuka, one kill for us, but we have double buff. Let's just show you. I jump onto him, I try to predict where he's jumping, I use my S2 into the direction where he's going to be, and then I jump furthermore so that he gets more damage. And as you guys just saw, if you use S2 and then you recollect the shuriken, the cooldown is getting reduced. This was really good. So, for you guys, what did I do in that team fight? First of all, I used my S2 to pull the Morad back. He's getting knocked back. and can't use any skills while doing that. And then I flicker behind him. So first, Zuka is not in range. He needs to put more distance till he gets to me. Then I charge my S1 because I know I can hit the Murad very quickly and the Zuka when he comes towards me. So they both get hit by my S1. And a thing that I did as well is that I cancel my S1 as quick as possible. So you do quick burst damage. You can charge your S1 very long, then it does a lot of damage. But in between 0 and 0.75 seconds, you do the same amount of damage regardless if you charge or not. So you can activate S1, S1, and it will cancel and you will still do decent amount of damage. So usually you won't be able to charge fully in teamfights, except if you use your flicker in combination with your S1 to redirect your S1 charge so that you can hit multiple people with your S1. I will show you later how I did it. Like, there will come later fight where I do the flicker S1 trick. So that will be really good for you guys to see as well. Right now we are waiting for Zuka to come, since he's going to be in his late. Batman's already camping again. Okay, right here I'm switching form. I use my S2. S2 is good to see. They are getting CC'd and they can't move anymore. Like, S2 is really good. If you can find the right opponent, the right opening to use the S2, then it's really good. And especially like I showed you in the combo guide, if you use your shurikens before and then collect your S2 while doing, when you collect your S2 while doing S2, your S2 is getting a cooldown reduction as well, and you can use your S2 once more. Right here, that you saw the S1 flicker combo, and let me slow that fight down for you. So first of all, I use my S2, then I use my S1, then I use my S1 again to gap close. I switch forms, I use my S2 to push the Talanas back, I activate my S1 to charge, and then I use my flicker to redirect my S1 charge, and I hit both Murad and Talanas. So I hope you guys enjoyed this little breakdown of the team fight I just showed you. As you guys can see, if you switch forms from your melee form to your assassin form, or if you call it, I think people call it half moon and full moon form, you get additional movement speed as well, movement speed and attack speed. And if you switch from assassin form to warrior form, you get additional AD and you do AoE damage to your surroundings. I think I didn't mention the builds yet. So Yena, this build I'm using right now is the most popular build you can go for in King of Glory. It provides you great sustain, decent amount of damage. You still have Spear of Longinus and you have Fenrir for a lot of burst damage when you're using your S1. You can also use the other build. Is more situational when you are in a lead position and you are pretty much snowballing the game. Then you can go for the Spear of Longinus, Boots, Hercules Madness, Omni, Fenrir and Blade of Eternity. For Akana, I showed you guys the Tanky, Bruiser, Page, Benevolence, 9 times Inimitable and 1 times Atrocity. Just one Atrocity gives you the chance to crit a lot while using your when you jump in. and then auto attack a bit, jump in again, auto attack a bit. She will do some crits and it will do a lot of damage. It's just like a lot of pro players go for the one atrocity in the Akana, just because the chance if you crit once is in AOV pretty high. Like you have 1.6%, but considering the percentage, you are critting a lot. And then skewer for the armor penetration. So this build and Akana Page makes Yena. You still have the assassin features, but you are more bruiser type. You're not too squishy. And right here, I use the minion gap closer combo. S1 onto the minion, then S2 to the Talanath, and then you jump on top of her so that you trigger the silence combo. And then I switch to S3 to do additional AoE damage to her. Just see, I'm charging my S1, doing a lot of damage, but we overcommitted by trying to kill Murad, even though, yeah, we just used all our skills and we had no tools anymore to escape, since we used the flicker right next to the Nexus, and then we killed the Murad as well. Right now I'm switching to Gilded Grief because I feel like Vera has a lot of CC and super, so I can avoid some CC or reduce the CC by getting Gilded. In the laning phase, usually I go for the armor boots since it will help you greatly in the laning phase, going for the 1v1. And later on for the team fights, you should always switch to the Gilded Grease boots to get the CC reduction by 30%. We are in a winning position right now. We got two tier 3 towers, while they like we didn't even lose one single tower yet. 28-4. So we're doing really well. Just try to push to tier 3 now, or we go for a dive. Let's see. I see Baldum use the ultimate on Talanas. I'm charging my S1 because I know she can't dodge the fully charged S1, and it did a lot of damage. So S1 is tricky to use correctly in a teamfight. It's fully charged, is very hard to hit. If you do the S1 cancelling, you can do quick damage. But if you can charge fully in a teamfight and then redirect your S1 with flicker, you will do insane amount of damage in a teamfight. Also because you have Fenrir. Fenrir and S1 will do so much damage, it's crazy. So I hope you guys enjoyed this gameplay slash commentary slash guide I made for you guys. We pretty much explained everything about Yena, the Akana, the builds, the combos. Especially this time we did the combo guide. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. We did a little slow motion breakdown as well. I put a lot of effort in this, so leave a like and subscribe for more commentaries like this.